Hello friends, now we'll solve second lab program. The question is, consider the following schema for order database. Salesman, it contains salesman ID, name, city and commission. Second, customer table. Customer ID, customer name, city, grade and salesman ID. And third, table is orders. Order number, purchase amount, order date, customer ID and salesman ID. So you have to create three tables, salesman, customer and orders. Write SQL queries to first one. Count the customers with grades above Bangalore's average. You have to count the number of customers with grades above Bangalore's average. Find the name and numbers of all salesmen who had more than one customer. You have to find the name and numbers of all salesmen who had more than one customer. Then third, list all salesmen and indicate those who have and don't have customers in their cities. You have to display all the salesmen. Indicate those who have and don't have customers in their cities. Use union operation. You have to use union operation. Fourth question, create a view that finds the salesman who has the customer with the highest order of a day. You have to create a view that finds the salesman who has the customer with the highest order of a day. Then last one, demonstrate the delete operation by removing salesman with ID 1000. Okay, all this order must also be deleted. First, ER diagram. Okay, so there are three tables, salesman, customer and orders. Salesman, customer and order. Okay, these three are the entities in ER diagram and these all are the attributes. Salesman, salesman ID, attribute, name, city, commission, all are the attributes. Then customer. Customer is the entity. Which are the attributes of customer? Customer ID, customer name, city, grade. Okay. So here these all are the attributes. Salesman, this salesman ID, name, city, all are the attributes. Okay. Similarly for customer, customer ID, customer name, these all are the attributes in ER diagram. Similarly in order also. Order number, purchase amount, order date, customer ID, salesman ID, all are the attributes. Okay. So here salesman sell to customer. Salesman sell the product to customer. Salesman takes orders. Salesman takes the order. Orders received from customers. Orders received from customers. So these are the ER diagram. Clear, no? Next to schema diagram. Salesman contain salesman ID, name, city, commission. Customer contain customer ID, customer name, city, grade, salesman ID. And last one is order. Orders contain order number, purchase amount, order date, customer ID and salesman ID. So here salesman ID is the primary key. Customer is the primary key under customer table and order number is the primary key in order table. Okay. So this salesman ID is reference to salesman ID of salesman table. Okay, salesman ID of customer table is reference to salesman ID of salesman table. Similarly, customer ID of order table is reference to customer ID of customer table. Okay, and one more, salesman ID of order table is reference to salesman ID of salesman table. Okay, this is about the schema diagram. Next, first you have to create the tables. Okay, first create salesman table. Okay, first create salesman table. Here, salesman ID is the primary key. Salesman ID, number, name, varchar2, city, varchar2, all are the characters. Okay, if it is a number, if it is only numbers, then the data type is number. Commission. Okay, here we are mentioning the percentage. So that's why it is a varchar2. Okay, 25%. Percentage symbol comes here. So that's why it is character. Then primary key is what? Salesman ID. So here salesman ID is the primary key. Similarly, customer. Create table customer 1, customer ID, number. Okay, customer name, character, city, characters, grade, number, primary key, customer ID. So here customer ID is primary key. So this is primary key. Then salesman ID, references, salesman ID on delete, set null. Okay, so here salesman ID reference to salesman ID of salesman table. Okay, on delete, set null. Okay, whenever you delete, it set null. Next third table is orders. Okay, it contain what? Order number, purchase amount, order date, customer ID and salesman ID. So create the table. Order number, it's a number, size is 5, purchase amount is also number. Okay, 2 is the decimal point. Order date, date, data type, and primary key is order number. Okay, so here order number is the primary key. Then customer ID, references, customer of customer ID. So here customer ID is references to customer ID of customer table. Similarly, on delete, cascade. Okay, if you delete in one table, it also delete in other table also. Then salesman ID also. Salesman ID references salesman of salesman ID. On delete, cascade. Okay, salesman ID references to salesman ID of salesman table. On delete, cascade. Next, insert the values. Okay, insert into salesman table. Okay, so salesman table contain what? Salesman ID, all salesman ID, then salesman name, then city, then commission. Similarly, customer, customer ID, customer name, city, then grade, then salesman ID. Okay, then salesman ID, this same salesman ID you have to enter here. Okay, then next to orders. Okay, order number, amount, date, then okay, then customer ID and salesman ID. This is customer ID and this one is salesman ID. Okay, this is salesman ID and this one is customer ID. Enter here. Okay, so after inserting, these are the tables. Okay, salesman table contain these records, customer table these records, and orders this record. Okay, so before do the queries, first we'll insert the create the tables and insert the values. Okay, first create salesman table. Okay, select and run. So table get created. Next, second one is customer table. Create customer table, select and run. Next, third one is order table, select and run. Okay, after creating tables, then insert the values. Okay, go on insert. Okay, so all 5 salesman records are inserted. Next to customer. Second record. Okay, similarly insert all 5 records. Next, order table. So now display all the tables. Select for display salesman table. This is salesman table. Next customer table. Next to order table. Okay. Next to first question. Count the first question is, first query is, count the customers with grades above Bangalore's average. Okay, you have to count the number of customers with grades above Bangalore's average. Okay, so there are many customers out there. Okay, some customers from Bangalore, some customers from other cities. Okay, you have to find the average of Bangalore. Okay, there are three customers from Bangalore. Okay, 10, 12, customer ID 12, 13, customer 14, 10, 13, and 14. These three are the customers from Bangalore. Their grade is 100, 200, and 400. So total is 400 plus 200, 600 plus 100. Total is 700. So what is the average of this total grades from Bangalore? So 700. And there are three customers divided by 3. So 233 is the average grade from Bangalore. So to count the customers with grades above Bangalore's average. Okay. So this grade, okay. It is not more than 233. Okay, it should be more than above Bangalore's average. Bangalore's average is how much? 233. So 100 is not more than 233. So this will not count. Then 300, yes, 300 is more than 233, yes. 400, yes, more than 233. 200, no, 200 is not more than 233. So this one will not count. Then 400, yes, more than 233. So there are 1, 2, 3. Okay, there are 3 out there. Okay, so how many are 300? How many have grade 300? Only 1. And how many of your 400 grade? 2 are there. So 301, 402. Okay, so it count what? Customer ID 200, 300 1 time, 400 2 times. Let's select and run. So 300 only 1 time is there, 400 2 times are there. There, no? Okay. See here. Okay. So 300 1 time, 400 2 times. They are more than 233. The Bangalore average is how much? 233. Okay. So among these three, okay, all these three are the more than 233. This is less than 233. Even this one also less than 233. Okay. So 300 1 time, 400 2 times. The output is what? Grade 300 1 time, 400 2 times. Clear, no? Next, second question. Find the name and number of all salesmen who had more than one customer. Okay, we have to find how many salesmen have how many customers. Okay, if you see customer table, some customers have their salesmen. Okay, see this salesman, their customer is Preeti. This salesman, same salesman, but one more customer. Two customers are there. Salesman ID 1001 contain two customers. 2000 also contain two customers, Bhaskar and Chetan. These are the customers. Okay. Then 3000 only one customer. But salesman 4000 ID 4000 and 5000 don't have any customers. See, there are actually five salesmen are there. Okay, only 1000, 2000, 3000 have their customers, but 4000 and 5000 don't have any customers. This 4000, 5000 don't have any customers. Clear, no? Okay. So the question is, you have to find the name and their number of salesmen, number of all salesmen who had more than one customers. Okay. Who all are having more than one customer? See here, salesman ID 1001. Contain two customers. 1000 contain two customers. 2000 also two customers. But 3000 only one customers. So it displays what? 1000 and 2000. Select and run. See, 1000 and 2000 both salesmen have more than one customer. Next, third one. List all salesmen and indicate those who have and don't have customers in their cities. Use union operation. You have to display what? Salesman details. Okay, some customers have their salesman, some salesmen don't have customers. Okay, so you have to display. If they have the customers, if any salesmen have the customers, then you have to display their name. If salesmen don't have any customers, display no match. Okay, means don't have customers. You have to display salesman ID, salesman name, customer name, commission from salesman table and from customer table, because you need both the tables. Okay, from one table you can't display. Okay, pair salesman.ct equal to customer1.ct. How you identify whether he is having customer or not? Okay, if both salesman and customer have same city, meaning is what? They have the customers. Okay. Okay, so these are the cities. Okay, Bangalore, Chennai, Mangalore, like this. If the cities are matching, okay, these are all what? Customer cities. Okay, then see salesman. These are the salesman cities. Okay, if that city and customer city, salesman city and customer city, if they are matching, means what? They have the customers. So that's why salesman city and customer city, that must be match, union. You have to combine with the salesman ID, okay, name, no match. If they don't have, display no match. Okay, if the city is not matching, display no match. If city is matching, display the city name. Commission from salesman. Where? Not city. Okay, if city is not there, equal to any. Select city from customer. Okay, display the city. Okay, if the city is not matching, okay, if the city is not there, then display no match. Clear, no? And display in descending order according to name. Okay, so 4000 ID, don't have city, no match. Clear, no? Okay. With Kumar, Kumar is the customer name, okay, but he don't have any customer. Salesman, he don't have any customer, so that's why no match. Then no match, 5000 salesman ID, don't have any customers. Salesman 5000 and 4000 don't have any customers. Okay, this is customer table. Okay, 1000, 2000, 3000. Okay, 3000 only one customer. Okay, then 4000, 5000, they don't have any customers. 3000 have only one customer. So 4000, 5000, they don't have any customers. Salesman ID 4000, 5000 don't have any customers. 3000 have only one customer. Okay, 4000 don't have any customers, so that's why no match. Okay, 3000, okay, one customer is there, one customer is not there. 2000 is there. Okay, 5000 don't have any customer, so that's why displays no match. Clear, no? Next, creative view that finds the salesman who has the customer with the highest order of a day. Okay, so you have to find what? The highest order of the day. Okay, who ordered the highest amount, okay, of that particular day. So create view. You have to create a view. Okay, give one name, elite salesman 9. As select, your display order date, salesman ID, salesman name from salesman A, and from order B, where salesman ID equal to salesman ID from order and from salesman table. Okay, salesman table, salesman ID equal to salesman ID of order table. And purchase amount. Purchase amount must be what? Select max of purchase amount on the same day if they order more than, okay, who is ordered more amount, okay, on particular day. So highest amount. Okay, then display that amount. Okay, display that amount. If on the same day if they order two, okay, if for two orders are there, okay, you have to display what, which is having highest amount. Okay, from order C. Okay, C.orderDate equal to B.orderDate. Okay. Let's see here. First, create the table, create the view. The view name is Allied Salesman 9. Run. So the view is created and now display the view. Allied Salesman 9. Okay. See here. So this is all of the output. Okay. So on 4th May, salesman ID 1000, he ordered. Okay, it is highest one. Okay. On 9th March, two people have ordered. Okay. One is 1000 and one more is, we'll see. See the order table. Select star from order. Table name is orders. Okay, this is the order table. See here, on 4th May, only one, so it displays 1000. Okay, salesman ID 1000. Then on January 20, only one. January, February 24, only one. Okay, here, the two orders are there on 9th March, same date. One is 6650 and one more is 550. So which is the highest one? 6650 is the highest one. So the salesman ID is 1000. So 2000 not displayed, it displays what? Salesman ID 1000. Clear, no? Okay. If it is only one order, it displays that date. That is the maximum. If there are two orders out there on the same date, then see the maximum one. So 6650 is the maximum amount. That and the salesman ID is 1000, so it displays that date. Okay, on 9th March, two orders are there, but which is the highest one? 1001. Okay, the whose salesman ID is 1000, so it displays this date, this salesman ID, it not displays 2000. Next, last one, demonstrate the delete operation by removing salesman ID 1000. There are two salesman ID are there. Okay, salesman ID 1000, the two orders are there. Now display. Now delete. Whose salesman ID is 1000. Okay. So how to delete? Delete from salesman where salesman ID is equal to 1000. Okay, before delete. So there is 1000 is there. Okay, there is a 1000. Now I delete. Okay, one row get deleted. Now we display salesman. So 1000 is not displays. Clear, no? Okay, so this is about the second lab program. Clear, no? Okay, thank you.